Welcome to TV Station of 易经风水维新 TV. Today is Monday, July 31st, 2017. This is Stephanie, serving you the news of new religion of the world, Taiwan 维新圣教 of this week. First of all, we are going to take a look at the footage of Grand Master 混元禅师's footprint. Grand Master 混元禅师 went to 维新圣教 College,for surveying the construction progress of schoolhouse and students' learning situation of college student summer study camp. Take a look. Construction of schoolhouse in Weixin Shenjiao College and construction of Gui Guzi Wangchan Laozu golden sculpture are under processing aggressively. Grandmaster Hun Yuanchan Shi was concerned about the construction progress and construction status completely.On 19, he went to Weixin Shenjiao College listening to Associate Dean Mesley's presentation and then went to construction site to look over the situation. Except the construction itself, Grandmaster Hun Yuanchan Shi collected feedbacks from the construction workers, reminded importance of safety, notified environmental sanitation and so on. We hope the construction could be used in July in next year when the Weixin Shenjiao College officially established.So the timeline was quite tight. All the construction, including interior decoration, had to be completely done in the beginning of next year. Grandmaster Hun Yuanchan Shi exhorted things to be noticed over and over again during commencement ceremony. He reminded construction company to do construction firmly, avoid badly building with materials of poor quality, follow the timeline within 1 year without delaying Weixin Shenjiao College officially establishment.We all hoped the construction can be completed on time smoothly. After survey of the schoolhouse, Grandmaster Hun Yuanchan Shi had lunch together with Associate Dean Mesley, Master Yuan Ping, Master Yuan Gan, and students of college students' summer study camp. Meanwhile, they also updated the situation of the study camp and students' learning condition to Grandmaster Hun Yuanchan Shi.These students just came back from the tour on visiting branch temples in northern Taiwan, coming after with the knowledge sharing and intensive lectures. Students combined what they have seen in field trip and what they have learned from lectures to realize extra knowledge out of normal education system. The summer study camp made the students think differently and see widely for their future life. Grandmaster Hun Yuanchan Shi was very happy from the feedback and update.Weixin News, Weixin Shenjiao College. On July 20th, Grandmaster Hun Yuanchan Shi, together with virtuous fellows from Yijing University prospective lecturer class, went to Yunlin and Nantou for a one-day field trip.
On July 20th, Grandmaster Hun Yuanchan Shi, along with prospective lecturers, went to Yunlin and Nantou for outdoor teaching. In order to help students have the advanced understanding of the principles of feng shui, they held this field trip and hoped that students could gain practical experience through seeing rivers and mountains, geography, planned and arranged factories and temples by Yijing feng shui principles.Grandmaster Hun Yuanchan Shi visited Tianhu Shan Ziguang Temple in Gukeng Town. Master Yuan Jiao built this temple from nothing, brick by brick. With this chance, Grandmaster Hun Yuanchan Shi pressed Master Yuan Jiao that he had amazing willpower to be able to make unbearable situation bearable, and found the solution to pass the hard way. Master Yuan Jiao overcame difficulties to build temple for Dharma preaching.
圆教法师啊，他19岁就开始自己出家，在这里辛辛苦苦，一砖一瓦都是自己做。原来在这里荒山郊外，他都用心啊，师父给他啊的一个天命，就是这里是一个弘法的道场，所以圆教法师呢。他就在这里慢慢一步一脚印的建设起来，普渡了多少的名人，普渡了多少的士农工商，正是佛的本意，众生来到世间上有不同的众生，有不同的世间生活习惯，但是终归于一心，就是佛心，一个慈悲心，一个慈悲心的人。 就能够由心放出光明。所以这里圣名为慈光寺。
Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi instructed that this treasure land was dragon turned round to defend the host, and here had a unique geographic phenomenon called Kai Jing Qu Shui. It means mental host waters. Only water inside a nude is a treasure nude when you open it. Besides, he also shared an amazing story about lake, which located in front of temple. Water was sunk into the dry lake bed and came back when construction was complete.At noon, they went to Chairman Ling's company. Mr. Ling was ever being the class leader of the third intermediate class. He and his wife welcomed the virtuous fellows enthusiastically. Chairman Mr. Ling thanked the help of Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi. He consulted with Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi with the whole construction process of his new factory, included purchase location, set the orientation of the front gate and company's billboard in order to fit feng shui's principles. Mr. Ling also shared many impressive stories happened during construction. All Weixin virtuous fellows were concentrating on Mr. Ling's sharing.Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi instructed the principles of setting the orientation of the front gate, the tips to design the front gate and build a pool, advised on important aspects of construction, the arrangement on interior layout of factory and office building. The prospective lecturers were deeply satisfied by Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi's detailed teachings.Next, they visited Shadong Temple to worship Kasinga Zheng Chenggong, who was the first Han Chinese leader to hold political power in the history of Taiwan. Kasinga was known as the original ancestor who opened up Taiwan, which was why he was known as the sage king who opened up Taiwan and worshipped as a deity. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi had feng shui survey with students and introduced the geographic characteristic of the Shadong Temple.Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi instructed that Kasinga and his minister mentor Liu Guoxuan came to Taiwan. Their destiny was to protect Chinese culture and world peace in the future. Kasinga, he opened up Taiwan and waited Wang Chan Lao Zu descend to mundane world. They did efforts to resolve grievances of Chinese ancestors and cross-strait peace.The field trip ended at Shou Tian Temple in Nantou, Songboling. After worshipping Xuan Tian Shangdi, Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi told, according to feng shui guidelines, whenever you went, you should take into account campus directions. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi instructed that the Dharma characteristic of Xuan Tian Shangdi, and we should thank Xuan Tian Shangdi and Kasinga because they opened thousand heavenly gates for the future 5,000 years of a bright world. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi brought happiness to students with magnificent Dharma. This field trip was intensive and included wondrous Dharma, such like feng shui treasure land, the spiritual location, and temple's geographic characteristic. Weixin News.
Take a break. We will come back soon. New religion, Weixin Sheng Jiao, boasts a variety of social connections, including community college for Yi Jing education, holding teacher training summer study camp, which introduces Yi Jing into mainstream education, participating international religious exchanges, and hosting cross-strait academic forums.We are keen in urban planning and providing multiple social services, such as Yang House Survey, consulting service in each branch temple, and campus reconstruction after the 9-1 earthquake. Most significantly, we cross the boundary which stands between religions and participate in important rituals of different religions. With an altruistic mind,Weixin Sheng Jiao assists temples for their construction, reconstruction, and planning by offering feng shui advice. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi guides people to learn Yi Jing feng shui and breaks the boundary of religions and nations. How he influences the people across China, Taiwan, and people around the world can be answered in today's Weixin feature story. The practitioner of Yi, Grandmaster 混元禅师。Hello, everyone. 阿弥陀佛。Year 1982 is a turning point of Grandmaster 混元禅师. We are wondering what happened to him in that year, made him give up his successful business in measure. Let us keep serving you the stories about Grandmaster 混元禅师. In year 1982 spring, Grandmaster 混元禅师 went to Rayfang Industrial Park in New Taipei City for measure.At his age 39, he suddenly felt severe waist soreness, and his feet was weak without any energy. It was too painful to work. So he put aside his work and went to emergency room of Miners Hospital immediately. After diagnosed by the doctors, it was due to his kidney deficiency. He was treated.With painkiller injection. Then eventually, he used his last energy, went home. He would never forget that day because it was the birthday of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva. After returning back to Taichung, Grandmaster 混元禅师 reached out to medical treatments almost everywhere he knew. However, his condition did not get better at all.At that time, he was busy on land replotting project, so he forgot his pain during the daytime. Later in the evening, the pain was intolerable and almost killed him. His face was swollen and he could not urinate. Through further examination, he was informed that one of his kidney was shrunk and the other one was inflamed and swollen.At that time, he felt desperate and worried about his wife and three very young kids so badly. He had tried treatment both from the Chinese medicine and the Western medicine. When he almost gave up, one of his friends, Mr. Hong, introduced him to visit Mother Xie in Longfenggong in Xinying Township, Tainan City. Mr. Yang Laowen,Father of Mother Xie was the first person who had attained Buddhahood by practicing the Dharma of Amitabha. Amitabha reincarnated as Mr. Yang Laowen to rescue people from suffering. Coming after, Mr. Yang Laowen passed the Dharma to his daughter Mother Xie, and Mother Xie practiced the Dharma of Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva together with her daughter.Teacher Xie. When Grandmaster 混元禅师 visited Longfenggong for help, Mother Xie and her daughter asked Grandmaster 混元禅师 walk to the third floor to wait. Even he was very sick at that time. They have been waiting over 3 hours, but no one reached out to them. So they can only wait with one firmly belief for healthy.After a long time, Teacher Xie reached out to them and instructed Grandmaster 混元禅师 starting practice Avalokiteshvara Bodhisattva Dharma. She wrote some words on a white paper with, The best place to find a helping hand is at the end of your arm, and the best helping hand is your true self.She also exhorted Grandmaster 混元禅师 keep reciting Amitabha Buddha's name, 南无阿弥陀佛 all the time. Then Teacher Xie told Grandmaster 混元禅师 that he did not get ill and asked him to come back in 7 days, and kept in mind what happened in those days. This was the starting pointthat the heaven and man joined as one, from Wang Chan Lao Zu and Grandmaster 混元禅师. Why Teacher Xie said Grandmaster 混元禅师 did not get sick? Please join us with feature story next week. We will tell you more. Thank you for watching today's feature story. See you next week. Take a break. We will come back soon. For this week's education news, on July 24th, the opening ceremony of College Architectural Design and Feng Shui College Student Summer Program was held in Weixin Shenjiao College. This course is designed for every architectural designer and interior design college student around Taiwan, which they could utilize their specialties with Yijing Feng Shui principles to bring peace to their family and work, help others, and make contribution to society.
On July the 24th, the Weixin Shengjiao College held an opening ceremony of the 2017 Architecture, Design, and Feng Shui College Student Summer Program. The Grand Master Hu Nianchanshi was presiding the ceremony and encouraged the students coming from the architecture, interior design, and other related college departments across the country to learn the principles of feng shui well, so that they can build safe and peaceful residential buildings, thus contributing to social peace and harmony. In his speech, the grandmaster made the following instruction.
你们是学习建筑与风水，那么平时我们在学习的过程都是在室内趴在桌子上电脑前设计学习设计规划，但是这一期的你们看到旁边工程都在动，这个你们有时间就可以现场实习，不然过去有很多建筑师画图员对于现场结构画图跟施工出来的结果不一样的很多啊，那么你们这一期啊，发现你们是最有福气的人啊。我们维新圣教义经大学建筑啊与风水设计班呢 这个是非常重要的。平常我们画图很简单，你要再加上平安，这个是不简单。而你们未来为人设计，我是设计平安的房子给大家住，设计平安的房子给大家住，这就是风水学啊，很重要的。
The president of Weixin Shengjiao College, Chen Liyue, quoted a sentence from a book by the renowned architect Han Baode. If you are a Chinese architect and do not understand feng shui, you cannot avoid confusion. Mr. Chen thus reminded the students to not only study feng shui, but to apply its principles in order to provide public with safe and peaceful living environment. Speaking from his personal experience as an architect, Master Yuan Quan, who is the head of the summer program, advised the students to grasp this invaluable opportunity and diligently study the wondrous dharma of feng shui and penetrate the principles of feng shui so that they can provide public with peace. Director Wang of the Yijing University, together with Master Yuan Ping, Master Yuan Xian, and other masters who teach the classes, took turns to make a speech. They reminded the students to make use of this favorable opportunity and strive for the sake of themselves and in the service of others. Afterwards, the students made a pledge to use their knowledge for public good and do no harm. The ceremony thus concluded. Weixin News Summary Report.
During summer vacation, another college student program, the 17th College Student Summer Study Camp, was processing in Weixin Shenjiao College. Let's take a look at the footage of Wu Qingji, the former Minister of Education and the head principal of Taiwan University of Education, having a speech to students on July 19th for further understanding about variety courses of Yijing and Health, Yijing and Technology. Take a look.
The summer program for college students at Weixin Shenjiao College and the visiting route of Northern Branch Temples and back to the college to listen to a wonderful lecture course. All of them learned about life knowledge which we could find in the books and open their mind to go on a bright life. Principal Wu Qingji, who is belonged to Taiwan University of Education and even the former Education Minister Deputy First, and instructed to the students about the concept and implementation of General Education in University. Principal Wu pointed that the goal of general education is to promote the five way of life. Students need to grow multivariate, based on life education to learn how to be kind and considerate to people and build a positive life.With the spirit of lifelong learning to make it become your habit and keep learning and growing. With the process of totally learning to teach efficiently and make students to obtain a good learning environment. With the garden of healthy campus to offer students to have a beneficial environment. Followed by Master Yuan Yao to teach students about the philosophy of Yijing and His.Through the lead of Tai Chi Quan to challenge students to have a healthy body. Students follow Master Yuan Yao to practice and improve their body. After practicing, Master Yuan Ting taught students the application of Yi Jing and science and told them the difference between antiquity and now through different cases. Besides those, Master Yuan Ting also taught students how to use Yi Jing in different applications.Master Yuan Tong led students to have an aboriginal dance. Everyone followed by Master Yuan Tong and the counselors to sing and dancing, that the students could exercise and had more spirit to continue the wonderful course. Weixin News at Weixin Shenjiao College.
New religion of the world Taiwan Weixin Shenjiao boasts modern and practical Yijing Feng Shui culture.Weixin News is dedicated to providing you with the most abundant and diverse news about the development of Weixin Shenjiao world. Thank you for tuning in today. Please join us on Monday evening at 11:30 p.m., Tuesday morning at 11:30 a.m. and 4:30 p.m. Wang Chan Lao Zu bless you and your family. See you next week.